Daniel here to talk VariAudio secrets. VariAudio is used to change the pitch of monophonic sources like vocals, and there's a few ways to make it easier and more effective to use, starting with bounce selection. When listening to a vocal performance, there may be a section that could benefit from pitch correction. I have a small section in my song Someone Knows, for example.
Sometimes I feel like...
At this point, I could hold Alt and use the scissor tool to split the audio event before the last note. Then select the event, press Enter to open the sample editor, which changes the inspector options, and I then can select Edit VariAudio to analyze the audio. Notice, however, that the whole audio clip has been analyzed, instead of just the visible audio event from the project window. This can be a problem when dealing with longer vocal recordings, as it increases the analysis time even if you just want to work on a small section. Hit Ctrl Z to undo the analysis. And so to combat that, with the audio event still selected, go to Audio, Bounce Selection, and it will ask if we want to replace events. 100% of the time, you want to choose Replace in this case. Using Bounce Selection creates a new audio file and event that only consists of the selected audio clip, which we can also confirm in the Pull window by running the Find Selected in Pull key command, which I've assigned to Ctrl-Alt-F, which has been highlighted right here. Bounce Selection is faster than rendering audio, as it only handles offline processes and not any channel-based effects. So I'll press Enter again, and on the VariAudio, select Edit VariAudio. And now just the audio clip from the selected event is visible in the analysis. The next step involves adjusting the pitch segments. During the analysis process, you will usually find that the detected pitch segments include sibilants and non-tonal elements, like plosives and strong consonant sounds. So the first job in VariAudio is to get the pitch segments to match each note correctly. Before starting, make sure that the acoustic feedback button is engaged and that the smart controls is set to show all smart controls. Once I select the first note, which is sibilance, we can listen to each segment by pressing the left and right arrow key. The next two segments are a single note, so I want them combined. I'll highlight both, hover around the bottom until I see this glue icon, and it becomes one note. Let's check the rest. So the start of this note is above the segment boundary, so we could cut it as a separate segment, but it sounds fine to me, so I'll leave it. And that is just a bad cut on my part. So let's zoom out. If I want to do further processing like audio warping, it's better to remove the non-tonal elements in order to reduce artifacts. So particularly with some of the sibilant sounds I'm making, I can hold shift and drag at the start of a segment and make it not visible to VariAudio. Okay, that's the max it will allow here. I see here as well. Let's remove that. For longer sections of audio, you would continue that process. The last step is to make a macro to speed up the pitch detection analysis. I have a macro called Bounce and Edit VariAudio, which does what the name says. I've assigned it to the hash key, which is also known as the sharp symbol in sheet music notation, and that makes it easier to remember. I've undone my changes, so let's select the event and run the macro. The prompt from Bounce Selection shows. I'll press Enter, which defaults to Replace. And the event has been analyzed by VariAudio. And also notice that the macro zooms in to ensure that all the notes are visible and ready for editing regardless of the cursor's position. Let's go to the key command window to see the steps in a bit more detail. Under Edit, key commands, and let's scroll down to Bounce and Edit VariAudio. Zoom in on the steps. The first step is to bounce select, followed by opening the sample editor, specifically in the lower zone. And despite the name, we are analyzing the audio, then selecting the VariAudio tool and selecting all notes, then running the zoom to selection key command and deselecting all notes. Mini rant, Steinberg should make a preference setting for bounce selection that allows us to set replace as the default answer, as we have to always press enter after running the key command for the bounce process to complete. So consider this a bonus tip for those using Windows. We can use AutoHotKey as a workaround. See my video on customizing Cubase with AutoHotKey on how to install it. If I minimize and run the AutoHotKey script I've written by double clicking, let me go back to Cubase, undo my action, and then with the event still selected, run my macro again. I didn't press enter and the same steps have executed successfully. I'll try running the macro again on a vocal sample from Media Bay. I've dragged. Let's just zoom out. So with the event already selected, let me press the hash key. The same successful result has occurred. So let's have a quick look at the AutoHotKey script. Let's minimize Cubase and open the file by right-clicking edit script. Let me drag VS Code. So the first line makes sure we're only affecting Cubase 13, and it's lines 5 to 9 that are of interest concerning the macro. Using the hash key, I'm sending the hash key unaltered, then causing a half a second delay to account for the time it takes for the bouncing of a selection to complete. Then I'm sending the enter command to effectively choose the replace option in the dialog window. The rest of the macro functions as expected. And until Steinberg add a preference option, this workaround will have to do for now. So that's a bunch of tips that should make VariAudio more effective. Like and share if this has been helpful. All in all, take care.